Check it out. This is your boy, Mr. Cicote, here for the Welling Court Mural Project here in Queens. And I'm here with the legendary Lady Pink. Now tell us, what are you doing here tonight?
Well, I'm here painting in my community. I did a Mayan warrior princess with a shrunken head, and we're beautifying the neighborhood.
Awesome, awesome. Now, what's your involvement in all of this? Why did you feel it was important for you to be part of this project?
Well, I think it's important that we educate everyone that spray paint, that graffiti, that public art and murals is not a scary thing. And when we beautify a community, it takes everyone to take responsibility of their own neighborhood.
Excellent, excellent. Now, you're known all over the place. You're known as one of the legends of painting. Now, what's the message that you're trying to get across with works like this? What's the meaning behind this character here that you use?
Well, the reason that we do this and the reason we painted on subway trains way back in the day was to bring artwork to all the common, ordinary people, the working class, regular folk who don't get a chance to go to galleries or museums. And we've taken artwork to, you know, just the rich people, and we have to bring it back to our very own, just to the ordinary people, put it out in the street, give it away, and beautify communities. I work with teenagers, we paint murals, we paint canvases for children's hospitals. I'm always working on exhibits, but it's always about, you know, giving the art away and helping people, and not just about profiting.
Excellent, excellent. Now, where are some places we can see your work?
Right underneath the N train over here in Astoria, not too far from here, but Ditmars Boulevard. There's two big, beautiful murals, and we're going to be painting them in June. We've got something there now, but there's always artwork in Astoria.
Well, where would you like to see this art form go from here forward?
Well, I would like to see more funding from the city for public artwork, and I would like to see public artwork in the outer boroughs, Brooklyn, Queens, the Bronx, Staten Island. All the art funding goes to Manhattan, it goes to Park Avenue, it goes to the rich. I want to see it out here. You know, they always slap advertising at us. I want to see fine art on the street.
Excellent. Any final words for any aspiring artists out there that you would like to know what it is that you do? You know, there's a lot of, you know, young ladies, not just, you know, regular graph artists, but there's a lot of young ladies that want to do this too. What would you like to tell them?
Well, I would like to tell everyone that if you have artistic skill and just a little bit of courage, go out there, take control of your own neighborhood, your own community, and just shape your environment to your wishes. And don't wait to ask permission. Don't ask, oh, may I please? Just go out there and do it.
Excellent, excellent. Mr. Cicote, Lady Pink, Kings of New York.
Alison Buxton.
And what is your involvement here with the Welling Court Mural Project?
My husband Garrison and I own Ad Hoc Art, and we were asked by Jonathan Ellis, who is one of the community spokespeople who helped organize this, and they asked us to help beautify their neighborhood. So
tell us about the process of bringing all these great artists, because you have artists from all over the world being part of this whole project. Now, explain to us the process of bringing everybody together for this.
Well, we first put a shout out to a lot of people that we'd worked with previously, such as Lady Pink and Cycle, and we did some work with Say, he's a friend of ours, and like Gaia, Darkclouds, Celso, a lot of the wonderful people on the other side, Michael DeFeo, and we just continued to put the word out, and they wanted to throw down, and it just so happened that like Sweet Tooth from London was in town to do a book signing at Deitch, and Remi and Stormie Mills were in town for another event, and everybody just kind of heard through the grapevine of wonderful artists what was going on, and they wanted to take part. So we decided to let some other people come on board very last minute, but it turns out to be a wonderful thing. So
awesome. What's been the feedback so far from everybody in the community?
Feedback has been wonderful. I couldn't have been more grateful for stumbling upon this awesome community. It was a sure pleasure to help revitalize a wonderful community that has been blighted for many decades and has since seen a gorgeous renovation and revitalization. And yeah, we've been very lucky.
Awesome. Mr. Cicote in the house, and I'm here with the lovely Jeanette, and she's actually the neighbor to this awesome piece that we're standing in front of. Now, how do you feel about having graph artists come into your house and painting the walls around it?
I gotta say, it's totally awesome. You know, the work that they did here is unbelievable. to get up in the morning, you walk out before we had graffiti here, you know, to and then just to come out and see this is unbelievable. It's beautiful.
Now, how did you feel when they came up to you and said that you were going to have artists coming to your neighborhood and painting the walls and putting all these beautiful pieces around? Well, how did that make you feel, knowing that, that your community was going to be beautified?
Actually, yeah, I was ecstatic about that, to see the art that these guys do. It's unbelievable. You know, it's beautiful, the artwork. If you go around and you see, it's awesome. I feel that for them to come out here, and we have a lot of school kids and stuff, and they go around the neighborhood and they see this colorful drawings and stuff, the art that they do. They love it, actually. I spoke to a lot of school kids and they said it was awesome to see this. Instead of that graffiti stuff that they had on the wall, profanity, it's totally different. They love it. Actually, they love it.
Is there anything you want to say to the world?
I got to say to the whole world, this is something that's beautiful. If this if this is something they want to do, like I said, this is art. This is art, you know, and the talent that they have, I cannot explain. You just got to be here to see this.
Awesome. Mr. Cicote, the lovely Jeanette, Kings of New York. All right, Mr. Cicote here with Garrison, one of the organizers of the Welling Court Mural Project. Tell us a few words about what this whole thing is about.
It's grassroots. It's for the people. It's not for the people with money. It's for everybody. It's just been so beautiful. Like this, I think as far as the all inclusivity, this has been the funnest project that we've worked on. As far as, I mean, we've been so blown away by the love and hospitality and the giving and the sharing that the people have expressed. So it's been such a treat. Like really, really amazing.
Two of the artists here at the Welling Court Mural Project in Queens. Would you like to introduce yourselves?
I'm Stormie Mills.
I'm Remi Ruff.
Very cool, very cool. Now, tell us, what's your involvement here at the Welling Court Mural Project?
Yeah, we just came and did this wall. So, yeah, just last week we heard about it and we happened to be here, so Garrison hooked it all up for us.
Now, what drove you to be part of this?
Well, I mean, it's not often we get to hang out because he's from Australia and I'm from the UK, so we got to hook up here and hang out and just paint the wall. It's kind of nice. Kind of nice to be invited.
Now, how do two artists from Australia and the UK wind up in Queens in an event like this?
I have no idea. I think the advent of the internet has been part of it. We both know John Fekner kind of through the net and just chatting to him. And he's been really supportive of what we're doing in Australia and in the UK. And we told him we were coming over and we'd like love to just hook up. And he was like, well, you need to talk to Garrison because he's organizing this massive event and you should come down and paint. And we did.
So now explain to us what this piece is all about.
It's just a combination of what we both do. I do these little bunny man characters that are just like mischievous little characters. And he's throwing out buckets, loads of color and imagination, and just, yeah.
Now, what's the message you're trying to convey with all your art put together? Like, what do you want the world to know about what it is that you guys do?
Ooh. A lot of my work is about isolation and the human condition. But I guess for this, it was like really good to be a part of, you know, like, because New York is the spiritual home of graffiti. And it was a really good opportunity for us to be involved in it and come here and paint something and kind of pay homage to that. So,
well, it looks great. Thank you for being part of this. Kings of New York, check it out.
Anything is possible. You know, it's like if you have the idea, or if you can see something that can actually be a reality.
What a wonderful world. I've seen skies of blue and clouds of white.